giving this morning. Hallelujah. And as usual, we just want to encourage each and every one. We take worship in its entirety here at the Church of God of Pembroke Pines. So we sing, we dance, we give our service, we give our time, and we also worship God with the fruits of our substance. As He's blessed us with jobs and as He's blessed us financially, we want to sow back into the kingdom of God so that He can reciprocate and we continue building His kingdom here on earth. And this morning, I'd like to draw our attention to the book of Matthew, chapter 13 and verse 8. And it says, "But other fell into good ground and brought forth fruit, some an hundredfold, some 60-fold, some 30-fold." And a principle which I think we've been hearing since the start of this year and even before is that principle of sowing and reaping. And it's a God-given principle. It's a law of God that what you sow is what you will reap. Nobody sows corn and then you reap avocado, right? You have to reap corn. It's the law of nature. It's the law that God abides to, that whatever you sow is what you will reap. And I chose this scripture this morning. It's one of the parables that Jesus taught His disciples. And as He went through and He spoke about the sower, and He spoke about the seed that the sower had, He said that as the sower moved through, some fell on stony ground, some fell on ground with thorns, right? Some fell on good ground. And one thing that remained, well, there are a couple of things that remain constant throughout that story. There's a sower, and there is seed, and there is ground. But what's different is the type of ground as the seed falls into the ground. And this morning I say to you that as God has given all of us seed, some of us have one seed, some of us have 1,000 seed, but God has blessed all of us with seed this morning. And what's important is what you do with that seed this morning. God gives you seed. Let it be that you sow His seed on good ground this morning. And I'm here to declare to you that I believe and I know for a fact that this church is good ground. God has blessed me bountifully since I've been a part of this ministry. This is good ground. It's reflected in that building that we have out there, that this is good ground this morning. And I'll close with two things. The first thing that I'll say is that everybody, you're going to spend your money some way, somehow. Trust me. Some way, somehow, your money is going to go. How are you going to sow that seed this morning? And the final thing is that just remember that commitment we've made, right? So Pastor would have shared a couple weeks ago, and, you know, we've encouraged everybody that, you know, if it's $50 that you put aside per week, we'll get to, how much is that, 12 weeks left? Well, it's less than 12 weeks now. So some of us have some making up to do. No pressure, just being humorous now. But, you know, let's put aside. It's a little bit and it adds up. And, you know, we're taking care of huge bills out there. But I believe this morning that as we sow into good ground, God will give back to us bountifully. Hallelujah. Could we stand together right now as we just welcome God to bless our tithes and offering? God, we stand on your words this morning. Lord, you said that heaven and earth will pass before one of your words will pass away, God. Thank you for this moment where we get to worship you, God, with what you've blessed us with, God. We're able to give a tangible gift back into your kingdom. God, this morning, we just ask that you bless our seed, God. Lord, this morning, we sow it back into you, and we are convinced without a shadow of a doubt, God, that this is good ground, dear Father. Do just as your words have said, God, and multiply the seed that we sow into your kingdom. We thank you right now as we proclaim your blessing and we praise you in advance. Let the people of God say amen and amen. And I invite our ushers just to serve the wonderful people of God. Hallelujah.
My God is awesome. He can move mountains. He
from the rain. is awesome. Can we give him praise? Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Oh, giver, healer, miracle maker, provider. Church are coming back to worship. If you're in fellowship one more time, and I want to let you know the angels are rejoicing in heaven right now for your presence. Let me remind you of a few things. Everyone is here for a reason. We're here for a different agenda. One of our agendas, we need comfort. And comfort cannot come from our friends or family. Comfort only comes from one awesome God, and his name is the comfort. Many of us are here because we had a bad report from the doctor. Oh, doctors, sometimes you... they smile, but you know the end of it when you see their face changes, get serious. They say, oh God, here it comes now, Lord, help me. Sometimes not the best report we have. But one of the greatest things is that we can come to this altar. And we can say, I worry not. I'm going to bring it all that to a God that can bear all these problems that we have. But we have to believe it to receive it. We have to have an expectation of greatness. We have to have an expectation of healing. And I know sometimes you have a troubled heart. I was saying in the first service, and I'll say it again. It's so good that you can watch this service as many times as you want. Tonight, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Isn't it great that you can have the Word of God coming right in your home, right in your smartphone, to give Him praise and honor and glory at all times? There's always a service in line for you. But I said earlier that every person has their own choices to make and their consequences. I must have said this more often, more sermons than I've ever said it before. But when I see someone like Sister Rosemarie Barnett, she has so many reasons for not coming out of her house, and she's here to praise God right now. She's here because she remembered during her time of surgery. She remembered when she was there only with the anesthesia, so with the doctor. She was saying, "Oh, Almighty God, you're here with me, and that's all matters right now. You're the healer, you're the miracle maker. And I'm going to come and praise you for that." She said, "Well, God started up with a paradise, a world that was so great." Says in the beginning, in the book of Genesis, there was light. God declared in darkness that let there be light, and the first day, and there was light. I think that is powerful. I think that is mighty that someone can say, let there be light, and there is light. I have to go and put my switch on. I have to put the switch on to get light. But God does not rely on the inventor of the light bulb. He did not have to consult Thomas Edison and others. He did not have to go to Benjamin Franklin, who was a part of developing electricity. Our God is light, and anywhere He is, there must be light. He's the source of light. So we have to go back to creation, just where Pastor is going today. That the sermon says, "Oh, a new heaven and new earth." No one wants to go through the book of Revelation. I've seen many people stay away from it. I've seen pastors avoid the book of Revelation, but we're going to go there today. And if you have your Bibles, I hope you do have your tools, then you go to Revelation chapter 21 and 22. As I said earlier, God has God. I'm not bright enough. I'm not intelligent enough. I haven't got the adequate education. But God, who speaks through me, is able to give me a memory that when I'm able to read something, I'm able to talk about it. God is the creator of everything that is good. Man is what contaminates it and make it bad. Day one, he says, we have to go back to Genesis. This is the way Pastor is going. What is this new heaven and new earth? Because in the first in Genesis, it says, and the Holy Spirit in verse 2 is hovering over the land of darkness. And God say, let there be light, and there was light. And the second day in Genesis, in the second day says, I'm going to separate the water from the land. And I'm going to make the sky. And the third day, God says, I'm going to separate the water from the land, and land was created. What a provider. He's going somewhere. He's making a plan. And on the third day, not only did he create the land, not on the second day with the sky, and provide light. But on the third day, he also created plants. Plants with seeds. Fruits bearing with seeds. So these seeds can be planted to multiply other seed for our provision. Our God is a mighty provider. And in the fourth day, he says, listen, the plants and everything that I'm creating, I'm making my plants need sunlight. So he created the sun and he created the moon. He created the stars for us on the fourth day. See, you have to understand what the sun gives. The sun provides energy. The sun provides miracles. The sun even provides vitamin D. Yes. Oh, God, it's now being bottled and being sold, and I heard vitamin D is good for the coronavirus too. Oh, and God knows everything before it's needed. Created that for us. The sun that we can have it during the day to provide all the energy. The moon that we're able to use at night, and the stars in the sky to provide light. And I want to remind you that only they provide stars in the sky. But in our eyes, if you look at each other, those beady eyes, you see a starlight as well. We got a star in our eyes as well that sparkles. And then the fifth day, God says, I'm going to make fishes. Where the fish are going to go in the ocean. And the birds for the sky. And God says, it was good. And the sixth day, God created all the land animals, all the critters, everything that you see that moves around those animals, God created those on the sixth day. But on the sixth day, he said, I've got to create male and female in my own image and my own likeness so they can have dominion over the entire world. You know, God wants us to have dominion over this world. Dominion to be in charge. And he didn't say it was good. When God created us, he said it was very good. What is happening in the world today, men have contaminated this world. People have made this world into a world of atrocities, of murders and liars, and people worship idols. That's what this world is all about. But I like in the book of Chronicles that we got something in the Bible to understand about this world. That God, from the beginning, is trying to get us back to paradise. He created a beautiful world for us. But we know that Adam and Eve, great, 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 great grandparents, messed it up. A fallen world. But even with that, he continues to find a way for redemption of us. And that's why his son, Jesus Christ, died for us. Because in Romans chapter 6, verse 23, it says, the wages of sin is what? Death. But the gift of God is eternal life. Who wants eternal life here? His gift, I want that gift. Second Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14 says, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I'll hear from God and forgive their sin and heal their land. God is going to create a new world and a new heaven. See, I'm setting this up to understand when we go to Revelation chapter 21. And it reads like this. The Apostle John, the angels of God met him, and he wrote this book to remind us as believers, to remind those who have not yet accepted Christ, that our God is going to remodel this wicked world. He's going to renovate this wicked world. He's going to transform this world that we live in that is miserable, not comforting, having us, matter of fact, I said earlier, let it slow down there. As they get older, it seems like the body seems to get breaking down. I told someone, age is a blessing from God. He said, Pastor, but all my time I'm spending is going from one doctor, they send me to one specialist, then this specialist finds out I'm not hearing well, then I got to go to the one who deals with the air. When I get over there, they say, I have another problem. All I'm doing is going to the doctor's office. I said, that's the blessing for getting old. You got to repair these things like your automobile. I had to make it fun to get her. But God has a plan for us, church. He has a perfect plan for us. He's reminding us in Revelation that from the start he wanted us to have a great life, but it was messed up and still being messed up to this day. But we as believers must remember the word of the book of Revelation. It says there in chapter 21, verse 1, then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. Pastor, not making this up. It's in the Bible. Then I saw a new. John is seeing this vision given to him by an angel from God. God wants to remind us, all believers there, and those who are not given to Christ, that he's going to create for us a world that will be peace and love in the name of Jesus Christ. We want to march for peace. We don't have to protest for peace. Jesus is returning to give us a peace that no one can understand. I saw a new heaven and a new earth. The first heaven and the first earth disappeared, and the sea vanished. Our God is preparing a world for us. We're going to have a new heaven. We're going to have a new earth that we won't have to need to see our specialist. We won't have to go to see the doctor. We're going to have an immortal body. I'm looking forward to that in the name of Jesus Christ. An immortal body. These words are credible. These words are guaranteed that Jesus will be coming. And when he returns, there'll be no more tears. There'll be no more suffering. There'll be no more discomfort. And Pastor and yourself won't have to go and see any more physician, because the physician is Jesus Christ. He's there with us in our presence. John is looking at this. It'll be a new home. A new earth for us. A new place for us to live. For us to praise God. For us to live the life that he has provided for us. It says that God's home, his people, we will worship with God. Do you remember the word Emmanuel? Emmanuel means what? God with us. Jesus in the incarnation took on flesh, and it said, Emmanuel. I want to let you know that was done those there 2,000 years ago to come now, that God is going to be living with us, and we're going to see him face to face. When we see Jesus, we see our Lord. What a day that is going to be. We won't say it's awesome. We would say this is incredible. This is spectacular. But only overcomers will enjoy that beauty. Only believers with the light of the world in them would have this opportunity to have a new world, a new earth, and a new heaven. Say those that don't believe, we're placing us fire of sulfur. I pray, oh God, for our families right now, our friends, our co-workers, that somebody needs to wake up and have a relationship with Jesus Christ, who the only one can save us. I would say right now that we are going to be in the Lamb book of life. We must believe it to receive it. Pastor, what is the Lamb Book of Life? It's a book that once we give our life to Christ and live a righteous life, our name will be in that book. If your name is going to be in that book, will you stand on your feet right now in the name of Jesus Christ? You want to be in that book. You want to have your name in that book. No one want to be in a fire salt. No one want to be in a river where there's no thing than burning. We want to be in the Lamb Book of Life. I've got to talk more about that. I want to get your focus on this if you don't understand. The book of Revelation is telling us that from the beginning, Almighty God corrected us. On the 6 days to die, and he says what? Not good. His work was
very good.
God wants us to be back in paradise. God wants us back to be in a world free of sickness. I know many of us have passed, I can't wait for that day. A day when we don't need to worry about sickness in our body. A day when we'll have our sight back in the name of Jesus Christ. If we can't see now, we'll be able to see again. Once I was blind, but now I can see. I was lost, but now I'm found. We have got to get the reality of it. Let me cast this again. In the beginning, God created a perfect world for us to live in. And human being messed it up. Our great-great-grandparents. But since that day of creation, God has not stopped to bring us back to that paradise he created for us in the first place. To this day, he's making every effort. Even me and every other pastors in the world and every evangelist and every Sunday school teacher and you yourself to remind people there's no other way around it. John is showing us a vision that we as overcomers will have a place to live where there's no more cancer. Who want to get, oh God Almighty, I rebuke cancer. Seizures, sickness, high blood pressure, whatever it might be. And in that city, you better receive this now, church. In that new city. So we have to get focused. This is not fantasy. This is not fictitious. This is the word of God telling us that we're going to have in heaven a river. On the side of that river, there be 12 trees. And these trees, oh God Almighty, will The leaves of the tree will be healing to the nation. The water will be the Holy Ghost. Oh God, we'll never thirst again. It's a world that God is working on from the day he created paradise. And my job and every job and your responsibility is to remind our people. If my people who are called don't memorize it, you gotta apply. If my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray. Pray. Seek my face. Turn from their wicked ways. I'll reach out to heaven. Heal this land. Here's another beauty that's happening in this new world. Right now, you have heard this thing about 666, that's for the devil. It's for devil's henchmen. It's for the beasts. That 666 is all for the murderers. 666 is all for liars. People are worshiping idols. We're going to have seven and all for it. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. A perfect number. 7 7 7 days of the week. 7 days of duration. Joshua went around the walls of Jericho. No weapons, just blowing instruments. And the walls of 7 at all. That 7 is the name. That 7. Let us transform that 7. Sister Marcia, we're going to transform that 7. That 7. I'm telling Sister Paula, we're going to transform that 7. That 7 will be the name of Jesus. Marked by his name. A new heaven. I don't know about you, my family, but I'm telling you, I get tired of this body of time. What about you? I don't want to go and do any more checkups. I don't want to go and see any more doctors. Dr. Jesus is in the house. Yes, Brother Kenny. Praise him, my son. Praise him. You get tired of being tired sometimes. Somebody's getting it. Tired of the reports you're getting. You're not good reports. But our God is saying, you are overcomers. Who's an overcomer in this house? We are overcomers. So Rosemary, I see you back there rejoicing. Oh, I feel like the Holy Ghost is in this place right now. Rosemary, you're going to have an immortal body. No more dialysis machine. Oh, hallelujah. And yes, Sedina, in the consolation to you and your husband, John, you will be meeting Jaden in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, son. You'll be seeing your son again. You'll be seeing your son again in this new world. Promise, guaranteed. The word of God says so. And the word of God says has to be perfect. Can't be wrong. Perfect number. Cannot identify this member of the church. She's here. She texted me this morning. She had no idea about this service, and I didn't plan to say this. But goosebump went all over my skin and on my spine. Sister Pastor, I've been waiting on my monies to come, and I finally got it. And I want to let you know, the seed of faith that she says she's in her text, that she's planting, was a perfect $700 in the name of Jesus Christ. Perfect. She said, I'm sowing this seed. Because God has blessed me. And I want to give him praise and honor because he's an awesome God. loves us. He will never stop recruiting us. Our family members were not accepting him. God will never stop. He said we should not stop. Sometimes your own children, grandchildren, your husband, wives, relatives, you wonder what life are they living. You don't want to send them into a fire or sulfur. Is there anyone who is bothered like I am? I'm worried. What more can we say? What more is it? The angel says to John, my words are credible. So you're going to wipe all the tears. I'm looking forward to that. Amen. Let me tell you, this fallen world, there are people who are punching daggers in your heart. Loved ones, when you see that they're going the opposite way. Some of them have gone into Christian home, Sunday school, and they've turned their back against our God. But the Bible says, his name is Emmanuel. In Hebrew, in English, it means God with us. We are going to be living with him in the name of Jesus Christ. We're going to be seeing him by bulbs, by ceiling lights, by electricity. There'll be no night, for we are the light of the world. What do I have to tell you to believe it? It's the word of God. We will be the light of the world. What more can we do to have our families and friends and everyone in the world come through the gates of this city? Can that city that we believe in, no murderers are allowed in. No liars are allowed in. Those who worship idols. Immoral activities won't be allowed in there. There's a curse upon you, will not enter. We are, Sir Pastor Massey, we are the light, Brother Chester. Amen. Let this little light shine. Amen. Let us be like beacon up on that hilltop. So someone will see our light and come to know Jesus Christ. Let us be ministers of that light. I feel an urge to pray for children. Those children who have gone astray. Children that they have watched grown and wonder why they have to go the opposite direction. Let's pray for children. Father, my heart burns heavy for young people. My heart is heavy, oh God, for the people of this world who continue to sin. People of this world that are getting on the sea, the world you're now in. Oh God, this world will be destroyed. The same world you created in the book of Genesis. The same world, oh God, that you did in 7 days. You rested on the seventh one. I know you did not need rest. God, we pray right now I've been raising my hand, holy hands. That our children, oh God, would make a U-turn. Our grandchildren make a U-turn. Our husbands, our wives, who don't know Christ as yet. All our relatives, our neighbors, our co-workers, to know that our God is awesome. Give him praises, an awesome God. An awesome God who loves us beyond our understanding. And he wants everyone to come back to paradise. His word is credible. The book of Revelation is the end book, reminding us that regardless, the book of Revelation reminding us that it doesn't matter what sin you have committed, our God wants us to make a U-turn and come to him. It doesn't matter what you have done, he wiped our slate clean. Because a loving God and a merciful God. Can you give him praise and honor? Thank you.
This is my prayer that you would bless me. This is my prayer that your hand be with me.
This is my prayer.